It's Miss Amy here. How was your week? Mine was pretty good. Well, it's so good to see you today. How many of you remember last week I gave you homework? If you did your homework, raise your hand. If you forgot to do your homework, raise both hands. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, stand up. Okay, everybody sit down. All right, so I had you read Ephesians chapter 6 about the armor of God. So in case you didn't get a chance to read it, right now you should run and get your Bible. Are you ready? On the count of three. 1, 2, 3, go. I got mine. Do you have yours? Okay, great. Start flipping over to Ephesians chapter 6, and we'll begin reading in verse 10. So, we've been talking about the fruit of the Spirit, and then we moved in now this week to the armor of God, and we're going to find out how those two things actually go together, okay? So, let's look at verse 10 in your Bible. It says, "Finally, let the Lord make you strong. Depend on His mighty power. Put on all of God's armor. Then you can remain strong against the devil's evil plans. Our fight is not against human beings. It is against the rulers, the authorities, and the powers of this dark world. It is against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly world." I'm going to stop right there. So this is saying our battle is not against people at all. And you know, sometimes it feels like it is. When somebody does something wrong to you, you might feel like you want to fight them. But the Lord says that our battle is spiritual. It's not against people. So how can we fight a spiritual battle? We're going to read a little bit more about this, but I think this is especially important. There's been a lot in the news this past week, and I think it can leave people feeling very upset and wondering, how do I fight against injustice? Well, the way we fight is through the Spirit, because it's a spiritual war, not against people, but against things like hate and evil and sadness and destruction and all of those things. So guess what? We talked about the fruit of the Spirit. And when you see hate, and this is a spiritual war, how do you think? Thinking about fruit of the Spirit, how do we fight hate? How about with love? When we see someone doing something unkind, how can we fight that? With the kindness of the Holy Spirit. Isn't that awesome? And you know what? The Spirit of God is strong. Remember we talked about how Jesus said to take heart, He has overcome the world. He is all powerful, and He puts His Spirit inside of you and inside of me. We have the power of God working in us and through us to make a difference in this world we live in. That is strong, awesome, powerful stuff, right? Okay, let's keep reading. And I'm actually going to put a picture on the screen of the armor of God, okay? Someone wearing armor. And when I read each piece of armor, I want you to point to it in the picture. Are you ready? Okay, let's pick up in verse 13. So put on all of God's armor. Do you see the armor? It says, "Evil days will come, but you will be able to stand up to anything. And after you have done everything you can, you will still be standing. So remain strong in the faith. Put on the belt of truth around your waist." Can you point to the belt of truth? "Put the armor of godliness on your chest." Can you point to the armor of godliness on the chest or a breastplate? Good job. "Wear on your feet what will prepare you to tell the good news of peace." Wow, I've never really thought much about armor for feet, but our feet are really important. That makes sense to protect them. Next it says, "Pick up the shield of faith With it, you can put out all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Lastly, put on the helmet of salvation. Those are all the pieces of armor, and those all protect you from everything. So these are spiritual pieces of armor, and it protects you against those spiritual attacks. But here's something interesting. The very last thing that's mentioned isn't a piece of armor that protects you. It's a piece of your equipment, and it's meant for you to be able to protect others, and that's the sword. It says in verse 17, "And take the sword of the Holy Spirit." The sword is God's word. So you not only are protected, but you get to pick up the sword of the Holy Spirit so that you can also defend and protect others with the word of God, with the fruit of the Spirit, all these things we've talked about. These are the spiritual tools that you have to fight this battle of ungodliness and sadness and hate and lies and untruth and things that we face in this world. Okay, let's take the picture down. Hey, there you are. Okay, so you are empowered by the Holy Spirit and you put on the full armor of God. Sometimes I just take these verses and I read them and I remind myself, I am putting on God's armor. I am protected. I don't need to fear. I don't need to be afraid. Instead, I am empowered by God to make a difference in other people's lives. So that means you too are empowered by God to make a difference in this world, in other people's lives. You don't need to be shy or scared or worried, but you can just know you have the armor of God and you are strong in the Lord. That's awesome. Okay guys, that's it for today. But don't forget, you need to memorize your scripture verse because I want to send you a specialized, personalized card in the mail. Okay, so our scripture for this month has been from Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23. Let's say it together. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. Whoo, good job. Okay, if you have that memorized, look in the description of this video below. Your parents can fill out a quick form and that way I can get your personalized card in the mail. Also, behind me you see some pool noodles. I also have a link in the description on how you can make a cool sword using some inexpensive pool noodles. Okay, because you know we've got the sword of the Spirit. All right, guys, it's great to see you. Starting next Sunday, we will be meeting again at Generations Church, and I will see you if you are at the 11 o'clock service. If not, that's okay. Please tune in to G Church or look at gchurch.net so you can watch the service online, and I look forward to seeing you. Bye.